So today we are back at Lestay Airport. We were here the last time when we were recording the Spano GTA speed record. And today we are gonna try to break the ultimate LEGO vehicle speed record, which is currently at 44.1 kilometers an hour. So for this we built a special vehicle and we will try to basically break the speed record, and we'll see how it goes. And yes, just for your information, it's early in the morning, it's very cold, and we are really dedicated to break the speed record. .7 now, we didn't even start.
Faster.
Same 35.6.
Yeah, 36.9.
Okay. Another 20 minutes, so now we are getting nervous.
That was nice. Right. Yeah.
.43.5.
How much?
.43.5. So we did like a triple flip and there is no damage on the model, so it seems. Let's see. Does it still steer? Yep. It steers. Everything is in order.
Yes. This should be it. I was driving 46.
46? Okay, let's see.
This is phenomenal.
Pleasure.
43.5.
How?
We almost broke the speed record. I mean, we were very, very, very close, which I think is a really good score for the first time. Because let's face it, this was our first try. This was Irnei's first purpose-built model just for breaking the speed record. And it was really, really, I mean, we tried. Irnei tried many times, and yeah, almost. So next time, I'm sure that next time we're gonna break the record. And then I'm gonna jump like woohoo!
So, we are back at Lestay Airport. This is the airport we also recorded Spano GTA at. We had 1 hour and 15 minutes to test our model. Unfortunately, we didn't break the speed record. We are missing half a kilometer an hour or something like that. So currently, Marxpek is still holding the record. But I do have some ideas for the improvement of the model. So we will try and improve the record, of course. What I'm thinking of is replacing the two rear wheels with the one from the BMW motorbike. And in the front I'll try to reduce the slack here, and I think I'll also add some suspension in the front, because when driving over bumps we were losing quite a lot of traction because there was no suspension, so the whole model was always bouncing. The idea behind this model was that I wanted to make it as light and simple as possible. So what I really tried to go for is, first, the driveline is created so there is as little friction as possible. So I'm using large gears, and there is two large gears are driving one small gear, and because of the way they are placed, when this gear drives in this direction and the other gear drives in the other direction, the forces that are driving the center gear are cancelled. So this one goes down, this one goes up, and the center gear has no side forces. So that's why there is very little or almost no friction here. So it's very efficient. Second thing was that along with the efficiency is that I used as little amount as number of pieces as possible. So this whole model is less than 250 pieces. I think it's around 232 something pieces. So to do that, I also use the motors, as you can see here, as structural support. Same in the front, the motors are also used as structural support. And lastly, the steering angle is it's made to only steer a few degrees, but I can see that I can, for the next version, I can even reduce it further. So the idea is that the model goes straight and as fast as possible. So simple, strong and light construction. And as you can see in the footage, we flipped the model a few times and there was no damage to it. Oh yes, of course I studied their videos before starting to make my own model. One thing I learned that they both use different systems for steering. So Marxpek used a small motor to turn the front wheel, while Racing Brake used two different setups to drive left and right wheels to steer. So I decided to use classical steering, because this way our speed doesn't decrease when steering. And I also checked the kind of gear ratios and setups they're using, and I tried to come up with a similar gear ratio, which I think we did, since we reached a similar speed. And yes, they were a good inspiration to start. So yeah, obviously if you're gonna use three wheels, you're gonna have less friction, because there is one less bearing, one less wheel to spin, one less bearing, one less basically one less element. And that's why for the next version, as I mentioned before, I'm also gonna try a three-wheeled version using the wheels from the new BMW motorbike. So maybe there will be advantages and we'll just have to try. Obviously we're using BuWizz Motors because they are currently the strongest LEGO compatible motors, and because out of the box they have a higher torque and speed than the buggy motors. So for the next big project is I'm just gonna try to improve the model, like I mentioned before. Bigger rear wheel, suspension in the front, try to use better bearings, probably gonna use turntables instead of these bearings, and we'll try to go faster next time. So if you're interested in the next hopefully better version of the Speed Breaker, please subscribe and hit that notification bell. Thank you.